follow rules. I just break them and call mine.
All I want is ring times. I just want that ring time. I want me a new one.
I'ma rise to the top, never will I fall.
Hello and welcome. Thanks for joining us. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the Miami Marlins taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. About to get started here. And on the hill today, Jeffrey Springs. And Singy, it's unique these days, but he's more of a pitch-to-contact type of guy.
Yeah, Boogie, he doesn't rely too heavily on the strikeout. He knows he needs to miss barrels, get some soft contact, let the defense do work behind him. And I think a guy like that can keep a good tempo, don't give hitters time to adjust or think. They can move through a ball game, and you look up, they're in line for a quality start. We'll see what he's got in this one.
Kemp gets it to first. And a quick out, number one.
Batting second, the third baseman, Gene
Segura. Gene Segura at the plate here. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. Back there. And that one is out of here. He circles the bases, and just like that, they're out front. It's 1-0.
He went up there 0-0 looking to do damage. I think he had his sights set on that pitch. He went and got it and circled the bases.
Luis Arraez stands in. That's in there. Strike one.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Up the middle, Franco to first, but it pulls him off the bag.
That's a play you expect your shortstop to make pretty much every time. Pretty routine. Hard to tell if he didn't get a great grip on it or the mechanics on him just broke down, but that gives this offense an extra out to work with.
Jazz Chisholm Jr. now. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Makes the grab, two down.
Man, he smoked that fastball. He's all over it. It's just frustrating when you can't get it to fall. Maybe next time up, he'll find a hole.
Ryan De La Cruz, the next up for the Marlins.
Ryan De La Cruz.
Going one. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. Brings it in for the third out. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. It's an early 1-0 lead. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Back here at Tropicana Field, getting the nod on the mound, Jesus Luzardo. And Singy, we were talking earlier about how he's doing a great job navigating through tough spots.
I've just been so impressed with when it seems like there's more pressure, he's more calm and settles in. He's done an incredible job with runners in scoring position. Most guys, they get a little tight, they start to aim the baseball, but for some reason, he gets looser, the ball comes out of his hand with more life, and he's able to wiggle off the hook of, you know, tough situations and get his team back in the dugout.
Next offering, pop foul off to the right out of play. In the dirt, Mercedes on to first. In time to get him, one away in the strikeout.
You hear people talk about letting the ball travel so often in terms of a hitting approach, and that's a great example why right there. If he's willing to let that curveball get a little deeper into the zone before he commits, he's way more likely to recognize that it's making a beeline for the dirt. On the other side, still a nice two-strike pitch, though.
Home team down a run as the Rays try and punch back down a run. The other way. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two away.
Batting third.
Now batting Wander Franco. Good power. Not great in the OBP department. And that's in there for strike one. They say it went. The wind of the pitch. And a swing and a miss. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Nothing doing for Tampa. And it remains 1-0. Dogs wanna bark and hounds wanna howl. And welcome back. Second inning set to go. Jorge Soler up at the plate. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. And that one fouled off. And here it comes. And it's through for a hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
Well, a swing like that can help you come out of the struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ball game, but all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
Abisail Garcia up to the plate. Swing and a foul straight back. The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. Gary Simmons, our plate umpire today, sort of has a reputation as a pitcher's umpire.
Yeah, a little bit of a wider zone than most, I'd say. And a wide zone can be tough to deal with as a hitter because you have to start expanding what you're looking for, covering both sides. And with the stuff guys have today, you're just not going to have a lot of success.
Fans don't really understand the familiarity and relationship players and coaches have with umpires. I mean, you see these guys a lot.
Yeah, but these guys are all out there trying to do their best and perform at a high level. So when you respect that, I think over time you can develop a relationship with some of these guys.
Now it's Yuli Gurriel. Good eye right there. As the game has moved along, we see more and more information supplied by teams about the umpires. I've been in club. This one swung on and hit well. Way back there. And he brings it in on the warning track. Yermin Mercedes getting ready to hit. That's in there. That's strike one. Soler leads off first with two down to the inning. Next pitch is outside. Out to short. Franco sends it to first, and that'll do it. One left for Miami, but they lead it 1-0. Bottom of the second. Now it's the DH, Brandon Lau. And he deals. And that's in for a strike. That misses. One ball, one strike. The pitch. And there's a foul ball.
Nothing but curveballs so far in the at-bat. Kind of makes it difficult as a hitter to know what to look for because you start wondering if he'll keep coming with it or if they'll try to speed you up.
He goes down looking.
Got a little bit of a questionable call on that fastball right there. It appeared to miss off the outside just a little bit, according to the electronic strike zone. But that's the type of location where you kind of have to understand that it's close enough to where you don't want to put the fate of your at-bat in the hands of the umpire. He did, and it got burned.
Fires to first on the run, and a couple of quick outs.
Batting six, the third baseman, Curtis Meade.
So two down now, and here is Curtis Meade looking for his first big league hit right here. Pitch misses, and that's ball one. Hard hit left side. Throws across the diamond. Out number three. Rays go in order. 1-2-3. They trail here. 1-0. All set for the start of the inning. And stepping in is the speedy John Birdie. Here comes a pitch. And first offering is fouled off. Ripped to third and caught.
Now batter.
Now the third baseman, Gene Segura, the solo homer his first time. In there, and it's 0-1. Segura, a former All-Star, batting second in today's lineup. He's been on a terrific run at the plate, hitting over 350 in his last 10. And the 0-2. Up the middle, and he knocks it down. The throw to first. Segura out in the play.
Good two-seam action right there. Running away from the batter. Rolled over it. Got the ground out.
Two outs. Base is empty. And at the plate for Miami, Luis Arraez. First offering, and it just misses. Just missed. In the air, out towards right center. Drops into the glove, and that is that. Miami down in order, but they still lead it 1-0. Set for the bottom of the third, and now the catcher for the Rays, Christian Bethencourt. And the pitch. And that one is in for a strike. Lizardo, in his fourth year, he throws a curveball, a four-seamer, a changeup, and he works in a sinker. Leadoff man retired here in the third.
Batting it. Second
base. Here's Tony Kemp. This is a guy you got to keep an eye on when he digs in. Definitely been known to drop a drag bunt from time to time. And he's pretty good at it, Chris.
Yeah, and he creates a sense of urgency for the defense because of the speed, because of the ability to put down that bunt.
Lined into left center, and that should be extra bases. Around first and hustling for second. And the tying runs at second base with a double.
Well, his hot hitting continues. He's been getting great results lately. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
And now it's Jose Siri. That's a strike, 0-1. And the 0-1. There's a strike.
I understand you want to try to gauge that guy's fastball, but you also have to be aggressive and ready to hit in your zone. Now you're in a tough spot.
And a pitch.
One ball, two strikes.
Swing and a ball lifted left field. De La Cruz pulls it down. Runner tags at second, and he's up to third safely with two gone.
No left field.
So the batting order turns over. Now it's Randy Arozarena, 0-1 so far. First pitch, not close. Kicks and fires. And it's fouled away. Two outs and one in scoring position. Got him swinging.
Sometimes he wears the emotion on the sleeve, but that's okay as long as he's getting results. And right there, thrilled with the punch out to get out of a jam. Yeah, we in go mode.
As we go to the top leading of the fourth, and now for the Marlins, the Jazz Chisholm Jr.
Jazz Chisholm Jr.
And ball one. Some nuggets on Jazz Chisholm. He's from the Bahamas, and he was born in 1998, signed with the Diamondbacks in 2015. Before he can make his major league debut, though, Arizona traded Jazz to Miami for Zach Gallen. He made his debut the following season, and then in 2022, he became an All-Star. Tosses to first, one up, one down.
Now batting, the left fielder, Ryan De La Cruz.
And up next for Miami, Ryan De La Cruz. He's 0 for 1. Fought off foul. One down, base is empty. And there's a strike. Got him looking for the K. Not sure about that call. Pitcher might have gotten a friendly strike three.
Well, that's got to call a strikeout. It just drives you crazy, man. As, you know, an opposite side hitter, you see that pitch coming in from that arm angle. You can tell just how far it is away, and you give up on the pitch. Well, that was clearly a way as it finished off the plate, and man, that's got to be frustrating.
Soler in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike. And he's already singled in this game. Swings and misses. That's strike two.
This guy's pounding the zone. Hitters don't have time to think in between pitches.
Next pitch one in ball. The dirt. Going to count one and two. Struck him out swinging. Pulled the string on the changeup.
I think the key is arm action on the changeup. When you can sell it like a fastball, you drop the velocity, you get the swinging mess, and you walk off the field.
Ready to go, bottom four. And now the right fielder, Josh Lowe. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. That's in there. It's 0-1.
But this guy's definitely a plus runner, but what I love about him is that he goes all out every single time, never takes a break. It's guys like that, even though they don't have the elite speed, the fact that they're consistent with it, they make moves on the base paths.
Takes it himself. Leadoff hitter retired in the fourth. Here's Wander Franco. He struck out swinging in his first at bat.
Well, he's looking great so far. It helps when over 80% of your first pitches are strikes. He might be able to go the distance if he keeps this up.
That's off the mark, and it's 1-1. That one missed.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
The wind of the pitch. This to third, and that chance handled. To first, Franco gone on the play.
The batter, number 8, designated hitter.
Lau at the plate. He was a strikeout victim his first time. Pitches in for a strike. 0-1. Now 1-1. Here's a 1-1. And a swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And the inning is over. Rays held in check here. They're down 1-0. Welcome back. Now it's the right fielder, Avisail Garcia.
Avisail.
Springs back to work. That misses. 1-0.
definitely a swing and miss slider down and in. He finished that really well. Just couldn't get him to offer at it.
Swing and a pop up. Foul territory for the catcher. Bethancourt makes the catch, and there's one gone.
The first baseman, number 10, Yulieski Gurriel.
Here's Gurriel. Fly to left his first time up. High fly ball lifted in the air right field. Low. Flashes the leather on the running catch.
The batter, the catcher, Yermin.
Yermin Mercedes, the next up for the Marlins. Grounded out his first time. And a good eye there. Next offering is in for a strike. Out towards right center field. Makes the catch, inning over. Nothing doing for the Marlins, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Harold Ramirez at the dish. A line in the pitch. On the corner for a strike, and it's 0-1.
Backdoored him with the breaking ball. Just got the corner. There's nothing you can really do with that.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Absolutely frozen on that heater right down the middle, and that's a pitch you're just not getting back. Now he's in a tough spot, especially after falling behind on a good first pitch.
And a 1-2. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Now fly ball to right center. Garcia makes the grab on the run.
The batter, the third baseman,
Curtis Meade, next to hit for the Rays. Grounded out his first time.
And there's one thing on his mind this at bat: get that first hit at the big league level.
Yeah, the pitch is in for a strike. 0-1.
Well, we call that keyholing. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
The 1-1 is fouled off.
Some real good life going through the zone on that one.
The pitch. This one blasted deep to left. Way out of here. Home run. His first homer in the majors, and they're going to have to send somebody to get that ball for him.
Always such a special moment. You know this is one of the biggest thrills of his life. He's got to be floating around the bases right now.
Yeah, he'll remember every detail of that at bat for years, as he should. It's a true once-in-a-lifetime event.
Now, Boog, there's so many times when a young player might wonder if he's ever even going to get to the big leagues and do something like this. Well, he doesn't have to wonder anymore.
So one out, nobody on. And here's the catcher, Christian Bethancourt. That's down and in.
Count 1-0.
That's in there. And the count even at 1.
Now, there's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if he can mix that in whenever he wants.
In there at the knees, 1-2. And a pitch. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Got him looking. Two gone.
Now batting.
Here's the second baseman, Tony Kemp. Doubled in his first AB. Yes. way inside, gets out of the way. A swing and a miss, and that's strike one.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
That one finds the zone, and it's one and two. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. Now he gets it to the pitcher covering the bag. And they do get the third out. The inning is over. One in the inning, and it comes from a rather unlikely power source. All even now at 1-1. Back now in Tampa Bay, here's a speed threat, John Birdie.
John Birdie.
The why to kick the pitch. There's a strike.
You know, these Marlins need to bring up the quality of their bats and specifically their swings. Just one extra base hit for them, so they haven't exactly been hitting the ball gap to gap or out of the park. That makes it really difficult to generate runs.
One, two now. Fouls that off to the left, and we'll do it again.
Well, this is a good time to step out of the box, take a deep breath, reset. A couple of changeups. Probably won't see another one here.
High fly ball down the left field line. That one carrying. Gone! Third home run of the season, and that gives them the lead. It's 2-1.
Looks like this guy was looking out over the plate, but he was ready to turn on the inside fastball. So direct to the pitch, absolutely blasted out of this ballpark.
Gene Segura, the next up for the Marlins. First pitch just misses. And that one missing low. Springs, maybe a little less aggressive on the mound right now after that home run, Chris.
Yeah, it seems that way. You know, guys, they can come out, feel good, but then all of a sudden get touched up a little bit, and they start trying to throw instead of pitch. They're not trusting their stuff.
There's a strike, 3-1. Well, he's been good for the most part. Is it going to take someone going out to the mound to maybe refocus him a bit?
Well, partner, every pitcher's a little different. I liken it to you. Sometimes you come in and you're not as focused, and I kind of do what it takes to get you on track, and then you have a great show. So perhaps it's the same with him. Nobody really wants their rhythm broken up, but sometimes they need a little pick-me-up.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Now it's the second baseman, Luis Arraez. And first offering is fouled off. Segura aboard here at first with nobody out. No pitch signaled now. And a balk is being called.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Lifted in the air down the left side, and that is foul. Swing and a bouncer. Tosses to first. Now one gone in the top of the sixth.
Now batting, the center fielder, Jazz Chisholm Jr.
So up next, Jazz Chisholm Jr. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, It's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Next offering misses. And one.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive, because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit, or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
Oh, he botches it.
Thanks, he's good.
Up next for the Marlins, the left fielder, Ryan De La Cruz.
And at the plate for Miami, Ryan De La Cruz. Swung on, belted. That one carrying. That's down. One hops off the wall. One runs in. The second run scores. Up by three, it's 4-1. The throw to third, and he's out trying for three.
The times that these guys take infield before ball games, they work on this play right here. And when it comes together perfectly, nice throw to the cutoff man, relay to third. You feel pretty good about cutting that guy off and keeping him from getting a triple and getting it out.
Hammers that one deep left field, and forget it. He flexes his power with that swing, his seventh home run of the season. And they add on. It's 5-1.
That's exactly the pitch he was looking for. Crushes it and hits it out of the ballpark.
Base is empty with two away. Abisail Garcia will hit next. First offering misses the mark. Line drive. That's a hit. So a two-out knock keeps the inning alive.
That's now three hits in a row for the offense. Nice line drive to the pull side right there, but he didn't spin off of it. That's the key. You still have to extend through the baseball in order to hit a line drive like that.
Yuli Gurriel comes up to hit, and a good fastball to start him off at strike one.
Well, they've been able to score four runs off him in this inning.
Here's the pitch. Runner goes. Chopped to the left side. Zips it to first. And that's the third out. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. It's now a 5-1 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Back here at Tropicana Field, stepping in, Jose Siri.
The center fielder.
And a pitch. Called strike right there.
Well, these Rays, as this game goes on, have to be more disciplined at the plate. Chasing pitches has been a big part of the story. We've seen it quite a bit today. It's been tough for them to make contact at times, and it just doesn't look like they're seeing it very well as a group.
And that's downstairs and outside.
And on the mound, you know, confidence has to be pretty high with all of the swings and misses. He's had them eaten out of the palm of his hand pretty much all game.
The 1-2. Lined, and that's a base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Right there, does a great job of staying in the big part of the field. Man, there are a lot of hits there.
Randy Arozarena next to hit for the Rays. Now snap throw to first.
No,
Siri back easily. Arozarena, the former rookie of the year, 28 years old, and he was born in Cuba. And that's downed away.
Outside of the United States, Cuba has more players and representatives in Cooperstown than any other country. Puerto Rico and the Dominican Republic are close behind.
Swing and a miss. And a count 1-1. Grounded to third. Could be two. Slings to second. And that's two.
I think there's always something pretty about watching a 5-4-3 double play get turned. I mean, just seeing the ball whipped around the diamond with quickness and accuracy, that was nice.
Two outs, base is empty. Josh Lowe next to hit for the Rays. There's a strike. On the corner for a strike, and it's 0-2.
In this situation, as the number two hitter, two out, nobody on, you want to be a table setter. Work the at-bat, get deep, whatever it takes, get on first base.
Three. Runs it up to 96 to record the punch-out. Brendan McKay gets handed the rock out of the pen. He's pitching on 2 days' rest. Here's the catcher, Yermin Mercedes.
Leading off for the Marlins, the catcher,
Yermin pitch.
Mercedes.
Up and in, and he gets out of the way.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Next pitch misses, and it's 2-0. Swings through that one.
2 balls, 1 strike.
The pitch. And a foul ball left side. And down on strikes he goes, and one gone.
Well, he clearly didn't recognize that curveball out of the hand and tried to check the swing, just went around too far, and you're hoping the umpire maybe missed it and they bail you out.
Birdie in the box now. No balls and a strike. And that one fouled off. The 0-2. Right side. Lowe pulls it down, and there's two gone.
The batter, the third baseman,
Gene Segura, the next to hit. He's already homered here in this one. And that's outside. And that is ball one. Missed inside with the curve.
When you get ahead in the count, there's no doubt that the success rate goes up. And that's what he's been doing. It's made a big impact for him in recent games.
Swing and a miss. And it's 2-1. That one ripped. And that should be extra bases. Now he turns and heads for second. The throw in. And into second easily with a two-out double.
Ripped that one down the line and kept it fair. And even when you hit it that far out front, you still have to keep your hands tight to your body so you don't hook around that baseball and put it in foul territory. And that right there was perfect.
Man at second here with two away. Luis Arraez, the next up for the Marlins. Next offering is in for a strike.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for a couple of strikes. Now back is against the wall. He's going to have to figure something out and figure it out quickly.
And now it's 1-2. Line drive, base hit down the line. Segura flying around third on his way home. He'll score, and the lead is up to 5.
You know, I was watching his rounds during batting practice today. So impressed with his ability to let the ball travel, go back up the middle and the other way. Sometimes when you step in the box during the game, you get a little anxious and you get away from that. But so far, I've seen him stay consistent with his pregame preparation.
And here is Jazz Chisholm Jr. At the belt and fires.
Nope, ball one.
time called during the pitch. And it looks like a balk has been called here. Runner at second, two down. Swing and a miss, and the count 1-2. And another ball.
It's a good take.
Man on second, two down. On the ground, right side, and it goes just foul. Ground ball to the right side, and that one handled. Throws to first, third out, and that ends the frame. They get a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. Seventh inning stretch time. It's the back here at the ballpark, bottom of the inning. The batter will be the
shortstop,
Wander Franco. And here it comes. There's a strike.
I really like how he's been attacking hitters early in at bats. He's thrown strikes on the first pitch to over 70% of the guys he's faced in this one.
Next one misses, and the count is 1-1. There's a strike.
He's been able to go inside as well as outside, effectively working both sides of the plate in this at bat.
In the dirt, gets it to first, and they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh.
Probably showing some pretty dominating stuff out there in this one, not just in terms of swing and miss, but also in terms of command. You know, all the strikeouts, they just kind of speak for themselves, but when you don't walk anyone, you're demonstrating that you have the confidence in your abilities to truly go right after opposing batters.
Lau in the box for the third time today as he takes that one off the plate. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Around first, heading for two. And that's a double.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Pitch was in and off the plate. So hard to do anything with the pitch in that location, but somehow he got the barrel to it and hit it well. Pretty amazing.
So, man aboard, Harold Ramirez. Next to hit for the Rays. First pitch, and he just misses.
Count 1-0.
Lau leads off second with one gone in the inning. Line drive, base hit, right center field. Now a long throw home. Not in time. He's safe. A run comes in on the play.
Back-to-back base hits, just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Here's the third baseman, Curtis Meade. He's already homered in this game. That's in there. Strike one. Ball one there. And there's a strike on the outside corner. And the count 1-2. That's to third. Birdie to second for one. On to first, double play. And that's the inning. So they get one run, two hits, no errors, and no one left on. We look ahead to inning number 8. It's the Marlins 6, the Rays 2. And welcome back. Now at the plate, Ryan De La Cruz.
The left fielder, Ryan
McKay, back to work. That catches the corner. That misses the zone. Ball one. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. That misses. Two balls and a strike. popped up. Foul territory behind the plate. And there's one down.
The batter, the designated hitter, Jorge Soler.
Now here's the Marlins DH, Jorge Soler.
Hit an absolute tape measure shot last time up.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. There's a strike.
I got a ball, one strike.
The 1-1 is fouled off. Here's a 1-2. That's a little bit low.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
And down on strikes. Two down.
Well, not much you can argue with there as a hitter. That pitch was dotted on the inside corner of the plate. I think even if he swings the bat, it blows him up and not really able to do anything with it anyhow. I think if you see that early, then perhaps you can pull those hands a little bit tighter and get the fat part of the bat to it. But I'd say overall, you just have to tip your cap on that one. Great execution.
Strike two.
I would say the game's close right now, but it's not out of reach either. I mean, these guys really need to put up a zero on the board just to maintain a little hope.
Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Yuli Gurriel, the next up for the Marlins. At a swing and a line drive at a right field. Low makes the play, and it's out number three. Marlins lead one. They lead it 6-2. Matt Barnes gets the nod out of the bullpen.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
Christian Bethencourt digs in now.
The catcher.
And the pitch. Ball one, no strikes. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there's just no one there to knock it down.
And now here is Tony Kemp. First offering misses badly for ball one.
Well, the leadoff man gets on. You want to minimize the threat by playing sound defense. Hopefully the pitcher can get a ball on the ground and they can roll him up for two.
The 1-1. High in the air, out to right. Garcia should have this one. And he makes the catch. And there's one down.
Now batting, the center fielder.
And at first, Jose Siri now at the plate. One for two. In for a strike. It's 0-1.
All one's the count.
Ground ball could be two. Feed to second. That's one. And it's a double play to end the inning. One hit in the inning, but nothing more than that. Ninth inning coming up. It's the Marlins 6, the Rays 2. Now in Tampa Bay, and now the catcher comes up to him. Yermin Mercedes. Now a new pitcher for the Rays, Pete Fairbanks.
Big swing and miss stuff right here, Boog. Averaging more than one strikeout per inning this season. So far, he's been pretty electric.
And the righty deals. Ground ball, left side. On to first, and the leadoff man retired here in the ninth.
John.
John Birdie at the plate. That's off the mark. Ball one. Fairbanks. In his fourth year, he features a four-seam fastball, a slider, and he works in a sinker.
No need to offer that pitch until you get to two strikes. It's just a low percentage of success when you want to try to go after that down and away pitch.
Swing and a miss, and now 2-2.
Well, and those hitters count sometimes can be a little too aggressive, and a good pitcher will play off of that. He's got to get a better pitch to hit.
And the right-hander deals up the middle, and it gets by him.
Now batting the third baseman, Gene.
Now the number two hitter, Gene Segura. That one's in there, 0-1. And there's a ball.
1-1.
The next offering misses. 2-1. Birdie stands at first with one out. That one's in there, and that is strike two.
That's a great take right there. Even though it's a strike, with the situation runner on first base, you want to keep the ball off the ground, and you swing at that pitch, most likely you roll into a double play.
Righty to the plate. On the ground, a short could be two. Goes to second, safe there. Here's the second baseman, Luis Arraez. Chris, baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball and is kind of different from the players that we see day in, day out. Late swing, foul to the left.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
Foul ball, it stays nothing and two. Singy, one of the things that's interesting is that guys really don't worry about swing and miss from an offense. Kemp tossed to second, but safe at first. It's a fielder's choice.
The center fielder, number two, Jazz Chisholm Jr.
Now here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Jazz Chisholm Jr. Slapped foul. The 0-1. And that's in for a strike.
Let's see if he's willing to use the whole field right here. Definitely pounding him away.
Corners are occupied with two down. Struck him out looking. Huge call, third strike against a big bat to end the inning. So they strand a pair. To the bottom of the ninth we go. Top of the order, Dua gets the mark. So bottom of the ninth, and now Randy Arozarena. Barnes back to work. Swings through that one for strike one. Barnes, a guy that comes at you with one of the biggest curveballs around. It's got a ton of movement. Now he breaks his bat. Slings to first. They get the out on Arozarena.
Got to feel pretty good for the pitcher. Absolutely sawed him off. Bat explodes. And then he makes an easy play on it. Pretty satisfying if you're out there on the ball.
And now the right fielder, Josh Lowe. That one finds the corner, and that is strike one.
And what makes it so good is the tilt and the late break to it. Kind of reminds me of Andy Pettit as far as how sharp that breaking ball is.
Out towards left center. That one gets down for a hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
The batter, number five.
I don't know how he's able to shoot that pitch the other way and still put something on it. That pitch was inside, and he let it get really deep. So pretty incredible hands to fight it off and still get good wood on it.
And first offering is fouled off. Who were some of the curveballs that you watched in your career that were difficult to deal with?
Now, Boog, I kind of liked hitting curveballs if it was coming from a right-hander, but from a left-hander, different story. Some of the nasty ones, Andy Pettit, Barry Zito.
And 1-2. Goes down swinging for the strikeout. Had him out front for strike three.
Well, obviously that was nowhere near the strike zone by the time it got to the plate. And people at home watching are thinking, what's he swinging at? But I'll tell you, some of the break guys snap off these days is just devastating. It can be so tough to recognize where a pitch like that's going to end up.
That one ripped right center field. That's down. One hops off the wall. Low coming home.
Well done. Narrows the deficit with the RBI there. Pretty much just a textbook double into the gap. And when you can drop one in there between the outfielders, you know you're making the turn at first. Just an excellent swing.
New pitcher for the Marlins, Dylan Floro.
He doesn't get a lot of strikeouts compared to other relievers, so he relies on getting that soft contact and the defense doing work behind him.
They'll have to be in their toes with him on the bump.
Harold Ramirez, next to hit for the Rays. That's in for a strike. Lau at second with two down. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
Not a swing you want to watch again.
Here's the 0-2. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
After four wins in a row, you start to think a little bit that you're on a roll, and that's the momentum that just takes on a life of its own. Guys start hitting up and down the lineup. Never know who's going to come up with the big hit, who's going to come out of the bullpen and get the big outs, but it's a good feeling.